Hi guys, I just finished a Zoom class and I thought it'd be a good idea to show you my setup because I know a lot of you guys are doing online classes right now and I'm a bit of a techie, so I got a really nifty setup right here. We got an amazing sound and I'll show you how to get good sound and I'll show you how to get good video also. Okay, so follow me, come with me, all right? So here I got a mixer. So I bought this mixer. It has a USB out, okay? So it's possible to feed everything that comes in this mixer directly into the computer right here, right? So that's one option. Just if you're thinking about getting good sound, this is really, really cool because what you can do is you buy this beast here of a mic, okay? That's really like a specialty mic for like giving classes, and it's called the Shure BLX4, and I tried many mics before and they always there was always some feedback or something wrong with them, okay? So or the sound was muffled or something was wrong. So this mic which I'm wearing right now, here we go, check this out, okay? So first of all, it's extremely comfortable and it doesn't feedback easy. That means that even if I'm feeding some sound right now, it doesn't pick up the sound and doesn't create the loop, okay? For a loop is basically the sound coming out of a speaker right here and then right into the mic, and then it creates that this loop and the sound becomes horrible and then you hear some feedback. So here's the setup. So I have the music coming in into a Bluetooth thing. So thinking of whatever, it's called Infinity, but there's a bunch of them on Amazon. And it's literally fed into one channel, right? So that's the music. So the music is directly from a source like an iPhone or anything else. And then I have my mic on another strip, right? So then I calibrate these two mics or two inputs so that it's, you know, the audience is getting something decent, right? So I'm asking them, is my mic too loud? Is the music too loud? Do I need to tweak stuff? So now here's the cool thing. Not all mixers have that, but this has literally what's it called an FX send. So it's another strip right here. And that what I can do is literally send that strip. So let's say in this case, it would be the music. Okay, so this strip, I send a certain amount of the sound into this output called FX send. And this output is my speaker, right? So I don't need to send my vocals. I just need for me to have a bit of reference sound by just, you know, putting this volume just a tad. So you can't put it really, really loud because again, the volume or the sound from the speaker will go back directly into your microphone. So that's really, really cool. And then you get proper sound to your clients. Now, let's do video. So now I changed my setup. So forget about the USB out. Now what I'm doing is I purchased this little beast here. Where is it? Where is it? Where's my beast? Okay, so here's, I purchased this Camlink adapter that's USB, plugged in directly USB into the computer. So then first what I did is I fed this Camlink and I used like a Canon camera, which I love. I use the Canon camera Vixia HF G30, which is like consumer on the verge becoming a semi-pro camera. So what I'm doing is I'm outputting a clean HDMI signal directly into the Camlink, right? And this clean HDMI signal goes into, let's say, a Zoom platform or anything else, right? So once you got that, you got professional or sort of way better than the 720p camera that's on board these suckers. So now here's one thing. If I tried it once, I used the USB signal on another USB port and the sound wasn't synced with the image, and that's a problem. So what I did, I outputted the sound from the phone's line, output, and I literally plugged it in into my lovely camera here, into the mic input. But you have to be careful because the mic input, when you plug in a line out into a mic input, the signal comes in very hot. So you have to calibrate. It's always better to record a bit lower, and so that in post you can tweak it, but you don't want it. You see the levels here, right here, levels, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. You have to be careful with that. So the sound coming out of a mixer, you have to put it fairly low, all right? So that said, I tried it today and it worked like a charm.
Then you go 5, 6, 7. So let's try it together. So I pre-count, 5, 6, 7, just walk it. 1, 2, 3, and 5, 6, 7. 1, right turn, 5, 6, 7. Spiral, on your button. Flare, here we go.
So I would recommend that setting if you want to beef up your video, you want to beef up your audio, but you can do it in two steps. You can basically take care of your audio first. I think one thing that is always left out of the game is audio. You know, people want good image, they invest in camera, but they don't think about clients' ears, okay? And usually I read a couple of things online that basically says that you don't get good audio, it's really hard to keep the attention of your clients. And right now I'm speaking onto iPhone directly, so the audio is just okay. All right, so also another thing, I heard many things about Apple computer not be able to stream. I read a bunch of forums. Yeah, they're not be able to stream. It's not possible. They're not made to stream. This is a 2016 MacBook, all right? So an old computer in terms of techies, and I have zero problem. No problem, no lag, no nothing. So it's perfect for Zoom. So Canon setup, Camlink, USB mixer, a really, really good mic. That makes a big difference. And also I'm using here some aperture lights to give a little punch to my image. Okay, sometimes you get a really good camera, but you forget about lighting, and you should do the opposite. You should get a cheap camera and invest in good lighting. You'll get a way better image, all right? So I hope it helps some people. If you have any questions, feel free to ask in the comments below. I'll be more than happy to answer. We're all in the same boat right now. We're all doing a lot of online classes. And if you have, like I said, comments, questions, feel free to drop it in the comments below. Much love, guys. Give us a like if you find the information useful. Don't forget to subscribe and see you in the next video. Take care, guys.